So if you're going to expand your business or even go into a new business in another country, in another international market, the thing to keep in mind for your marketing and for the business is just that the fundamentals are the same. The marketing is very similar. People are persuaded in similar ways. You know, the AIDA formula of marketing, attention, interest, desire, action, using call to actions, all that stuff is essentially the same. So getting people to subscribe to an email list, sending them follow-ups with autoresponse, retargeting them with retargeting ads, making upsell offers back. It's all the fundamentals of digital marketing are pretty much the same, regardless of what country you go and, you know, target with or try to sell to. There are some minor changes that you'll want to keep in mind, and we'll talk real quick about some of those things. Now, you'll certainly want to do competitive research in these other languages. It's the same thing with the fundamentals of an English market, where you're doing competitive research, you're looking and seeing what people are selling, you're looking at seeing what kind of ads they're running, all the things you've already learned throughout this course. You want to apply them, of course, in other languages and see how all those things work within that one little kind of micro world of, let's say, the German market. If you're going to sell into the German market in German, then you want to look and see who the German advertisers are, what the products are, what they're selling, what kind of copy they're using, what kind of headlines they use, you know, which ads that are being displayed with certain AdWords ads, things like that. That you'll want to pay attention to that. You want to observe and monitor the advertisers on any ad platform that you're thinking about going into, whether it's keyword-based, whether it's, you know, Facebook ad platform-based where you're running an ad, in news feeds, or whether it's, you know, display network, whether you're going to do SEO. Regardless of what it is, you need to observe and monitor, of course, the competitors in those areas. You want to examine product offers, pricing, and funnels. Again, the same thing you do in the English market. You want to see what they sell, how much they sell it for, how they're selling it, if they're upsells, downsells, those sorts of things. You know, let others do all the work for you. You don't need to reinvent the wheel. That's certainly the case in any different market in the world for any different country. You can take Zimbabwe, and right now someone's making money with a certain offer and a certain funnel and certain prices. And if you go in there, you do your proper research, you can see what that is, and you don't need to reinvent the wheel. You can do pretty much what they're already doing or similar, and most likely get similar results. That's just how it works. Now, you want to get a grasp on average CPC rates and conversions in these other markets. You want to run some tests. You want to really do some research and look into it. You can look at suggested bid prices on Facebook, in the Google network, in other ad networks. It'll kind of tell you what the average cost is or what you'd need to bid to be, let's say, number one for a certain keyword search. Or, of course, when you target a certain audience that you create for a certain market within the Facebook ad network. And so you'll see the suggested prices and the ranges. And so you can kind of do the numbers there on what kind of conversions you'd need in order to turn a profit. Now, copywriting, I mentioned this, it's going to be different based on cultural references, vocabulary, slang, etc. This is why you really need that consultant. You need someone that can look over the copy. Otherwise, you may embarrass yourself by doing a straight-up translation of your English marketing into, you know, French or another language. Things may not translate exactly over, at least from a marketing sense, and so it just may look terrible and, of course, convert terrible. So it's best to have somebody that's a native speaker from that country and understands the culture as well as the marketing that's being done in that country to have them review, you know, kind of your translated marketing and make some tweaks to it. The other thing to think about is payment systems, unfortunately, can sometimes be a challenge if you go after selling in different countries. Sometimes they all don't have the same, you know, Visa, MasterCard network or can do PayPal. Sometimes they have limitations on the types of payments. The world, again, is becoming smaller and smaller. Business is being done across the world a lot easier. So more and more payment systems are ubiquitous in these different nations. Most of these countries do now take PayPal. Not all of them, but most of them. But you definitely want to do that research and see how you can collect money from those countries before you go and build marketing in those countries. So that's obviously something you want to check out first. And as I said, highly recommended, hire a consultant in the country that you're going to target if you're going to do things with that native language. Very important not only to have your marketing materials reviewed, but also things from a cultural standpoint as far as, you know, do people buy your types of products in the country? Are they already buying them from competitors, which, of course, is a good thing? Or would they maybe not buy that because they just don't buy online courses as much? People aren't used to learning online. Whatever it is, you need to find that out. And of course, the only way to do that is to hire a consultant and kind of pick their brains and get them to kind of help you as a step one, stage one, before you actually go and do it. So definitely something you want to do.